This is a step-by-step tutorial for Coinbase Pro, where I go through all the functionality this crypto exchange has to offer. So if you're a beginner, you should definitely watch this video. Before we get started with the Coinbase Pro tutorial, I want to announce the first winner of my Bitcoin giveaway. So if you didn't know, for every video I upload this month, I give away $10 worth of Bitcoin if you like and comment the video. So if you want to have the chance for this video, please be sure to like and leave a comment. Otherwise, let's see the winner for the previous video. So this is the video that I'm going to award the winner for. It's the video how to buy Bitcoin using a limit order on Coinbase Pro. And you see I have it loaded here. There are 29 unique comments. Drum roll, please. The winner is Gabriel Anderson. Congrats, Gabriel. I see you already left your Bitcoin address there, so I'm going to send you $10 worth of Bitcoin. And now let's go back to our Coinbase Pro tutorial. Coinbase Pro is a popular crypto exchange, even though beginners might not know they can pay less fees with Coinbase when they use the platform because the two accounts are connected. I'm going to log in. If you already have an account with Coinbase, you should be able to log in into this webpage with the same account. So if you don't have a Coinbase account yet, check the link in the description. When you sign up with that link, we both receive $10 worth of Bitcoin. So once you log in, this is what you'll see. It might be intimidating at first, but I'm going through all of them and I'm going to explain this interface to you. It's an interface that traders use, but it's a very simplified one. So it's a good place to start and learn about trading if you want to. But even for beginners that just want to buy Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies at good prices, you can totally use this interface. So let's just start from the left. If I click here on select market, I can see all the cryptocurrency pairs that I can trade. With Coinbase Pro, it's very nice that we can trade with fiat money as well. Fiat money is the dollars, the euros, the pounds that we are using in our day-to-day lives. In my account, I only have euro available, but depending where you live or where you opened your account, you might have a USD or pounds as well. There are not many pairs here on Coinbase Pro. There are other exchanges that allow you to trade more pairs, but we'll have to do with what's listed here. You can see here all the pairs available for euro or your USD. USDC, it's a stable coin and its value is fixed to $1. Then we have Bitcoin. Bitcoin has a lot of pairs to trade here. DAI, it's only paired with Ethereum, and Ethereum, which only has two pairs. So most of the trades are done with Bitcoin and USDC. And for this example, we'll pick Bitcoin Euro. Next to it, we can see the current price of Bitcoin, how much it changed in the past 24 hours, and what's the volume traded for this pair in the past 24 hours. On the left-hand side, we have our current balance in Euro and in Bitcoin. And then two buttons to deposit and withdraw. If we click on deposit, then this window will pop up. And we can choose what type of asset we want to deposit. Let's say I want to deposit some euro. Depending where you live, you might have different options. Here in Europe, I have a SEPA transfer and from Coinbase.com. One great thing about Coinbase Pro is that you can easily switch funds from your Coinbase.com account and your Coinbase Pro account for free and instantly. So if you already have funds in Coinbase, you can easily transfer them to Coinbase Pro and start trading. If you do a bank transfer, it will tell you about the limits, about the processing times and the fees that are associated with it. And regarding fees, you can go and see them here. I'll also leave the link in the description. So these are the deposits and withdrawal fees. If I click continue here, it will give me the bank details that I need to send the funds to from my bank account to these bank details. The most important part here is to include this, this reference number that will associate the transfer to your account. So include this reference number in your transaction. Going back, if I click on Coinbase.com, you can see that I have some funds in my Coinbase.com account. And I'll just click on max to insert the full amount. And then there's no limit to do that, and the processing time is instant. And I'll just click deposit, and my deposit is complete. You can see my 10 euros here available for me to trade right now. If you want to move some Bitcoin to this platform, you click on deposit, select Bitcoin, and then you can choose from the Coinbase.com account if you have already some Bitcoin in your Coinbase account, or from a different wallet. This is your Bitcoin address, and you'll be able to send from your wallet to Coinbase Pro. In order to trade, you need to deposit the funds first. And then when you want to withdraw, you click on withdrawal and follow the same process. I click on Bitcoin. I can withdraw to a crypto address, to my external wallet. And one great thing about the Coinbase.pro account is that all the withdrawals are free. So you can have $10 worth of Bitcoin and you can draw that for free to your wallet. And this is great because most other exchanges, they will take a fee, which is around $3 to $5. So if you want to buy just $10 worth of Bitcoin, like the free Bitcoin you receive when you sign up with my affiliate link, then you'll have to pay $3 to $4 in order to withdraw that that amount. But with Coinbase Pro, you don't pay any withdrawal fee. That's why you can easily buy smaller amounts of cryptocurrency and withdraw them to your wallet where the safest. It's the same if you want to withdraw Euro. You can choose to withdraw to your Coinbase account. It's possible that in Coinbase.com you have better withdrawal options for your fiat money, for your USD or Euro. So you better check that first. Otherwise, you'll click on SEPA transfer or what kind of transfer, bank account transfer you can do from here, and you'll see the fees associated with it. In my case, it's 0.15 euros, so that's totally acceptable. And it will take 1 to 3 days to withdraw money to my bank account. That's all about depositing and withdrawal. Let's say we want to buy some Bitcoin, and we have a few options to do that. We can either buy at market price or limit and stop options, which I'll discuss in a minute. Buying at market price, it means it will buy at the current price, which is the one listed right here, and that it will trigger instantly. So I'll type in here that I want to buy for 10 euros. And when I place a buy order, this order will trigger instantly. And you can also see the fee right here, the fee that I'm going to pay for this transaction, which is listed here. So for under $10,000, the taker and maker fee is the same. It's at 0.5%, 0.05 euro is 0.5% from my 10 euros that I want to buy. When you buy at market price, you are a taker, you are taking from the market. But whenever you set a limit or a stop limit order, you are a maker. You set your own prices, so then you have lower fees associated with that. In the case of Coinbase Pro, unless you trade more than $5,000, this fee will be the same for taker and maker. So it won't make any difference if you buy at market or limit price. But with other exchanges, this difference might be much more significant. However, even the 0.5% fee, that's much lower than the Coinbase purchase. So if you want to buy from Coinbase, it's better if you use the Coinbase Pro platform. It will take from you much less money for every transaction. For the limit transaction, you set your own price that you want to buy at. For example, if I want to buy one Bitcoin, I can say I want to buy Bitcoin whenever the price is 5,000 euro. Or right now it's over 8,500. I'll say I just want to buy when it's 8,500. If you only know the amount you want to spend, for example, in our case, let's say I want 10 euros on this transaction, and you don't know how much Bitcoin is that, you'll just go on Google and type in 10 euro to BTC. And this is the amount you will want to buy. I'll just copy this and paste in it here. And this is how you know how much Bitcoin you'll buy for the amount you set. You'll see here that's around 10 euro. You can adjust this. And now it's under 10 euro. So if I place an order now, it will only trigger when the price of Bitcoin reaches 8,500. So you can see the order here in the open orders tab. But if you want to know more about the limit orders, I created a video especially for that. If you click on the card that appears on the top right corner, you can see that video here. A stop limit order, it's a bit different from the limit order because you can set at what price to actually open this trade. For example, I'll say that when the price of Bitcoin reaches 8,500 euros, I want to buy 10 euros worth of Bitcoin, but at the price of 8,000 euro. So this order will trigger only when the price of Bitcoin will drop to 8,500. And when the price will drop to that amount, then it will open this limit order like we did here. So instead of us coming to create a limit order when the price is at 8,500, we can create a stop order and it will trigger automatically. If you want to know more about stop limit order, I don't have a video yet, but when it's ready, I'll link it in the top right corner, so check it out. So if you want your trade to be triggered instantly, you'll just use a market order. Otherwise, if you want a limit order at your desired price, let's say I want to buy $10 worth of Bitcoin, I can click here on these are the sellers and these are the buyers. These are on the order book the people that are selling Bitcoin. This is the amount they are selling and this is for how much. The same here down below. This is the amount they are buying and this is the price of Bitcoin they are buying at. The spread is the difference between the sell order right here and the buy order right here, because they are not the same. So let's just say I want to buy Bitcoin at a lower price. I'll just choose my price. For this example, I'll just click on this one and adjust it a bit. And if I place the buy order and didn't go through because the price is too much compared to what I have, so I'll just lower this amount like that. I place a buy order. And now you can see my order here, the open one, and my price in the order book. This is the order that needs to be filled in order to receive my Bitcoin. You'll see is the next in the queue. So whenever someone will buy, either at market price or the sell price will reach this price, it will be filled in and I will have my Bitcoin. Until this order is filled in, it shouldn't take long, but I'll present you the rest of the interface. This is the price chart. Is displayed as candles. Coinbase Pro doesn't offer a lot of tools for traders. These are just basic ones, so it will be easy for you to get familiar with them. You can change here the time frame to 1 minute. This is how the price behaved in the past minutes. Each candle is 1 minute, or to 5 minutes, and so on and so forth. You can change from candles to line, and you can see the evolution of the price with this line. And only two technical analysis tools, the exponential moving average, 12 exponential moving average, and then the 26th exponential moving average. Below here you can see the buy orders, and these are the sell orders. And it's actually the translation of this order book here into this graph. On here you can see that my transaction was actually filled, so it disappeared from this list. I have now Bitcoin and I don't have Euro anymore. And here is the details of the order fill. I bought 0.001 Bitcoin at this price. This was the fee a few seconds ago. And here on the right hand side, you can see the trade history, all the buy and sell orders that have been filled in. If I want to do a sell order, I'll just click on sell. I'll go to market and this will be triggered instantly, or I can set a limit order or a stop limit order. Let's just see how a market order works. I'll just click on max and I'll sell my full Bitcoin amount. This is the fee and this is what I'll get in return. I place a sell order and this was filled instantly. And basically this is it. This is how you can buy and sell Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies, because this is available for any pair that you see here. This is Ethereum, for example. We have the same interface with the same details and use it in the same way. And if I go to orders, I can here create a new portfolio to have separated the balances in my account, or I can see my open orders. I don't have any now, but I can see the filled ones. These are the transactions that have been filled on my account and the fees that I paid, and all the details regarding the fees, you can read more about it here. If I go to portfolios, here I can see all my portfolios, but I can also see all the balances of the coins that I have on my account. I can see all the deposits. I can see all the withdrawals, and I can also deposit and withdraw from here, but they are the same steps as before. The profile settings will give me other options. For example, I can see the bank that I have linked with Coinbase right here. I can see the limits on my account, API settings, in case you need an API for external service to communicate with Coinbase Pro. The address book will let you add different addresses to this crypto exchange, so you can easily deposit and withdraw from these addresses. Here are the tax statements and another tab for taxes in case you need to use these features. And margin trading, which is not yet available. It will be soon this year, and you'll have to join a waitlist if you want to be part of that. And that's it. This is all I have to say about Coinbase Pro. In conclusion, it's a very easy to understand and learn exchange platform. It doesn't have a lot of coins, just a few pairs, but it gives you an easy to understand and easy to use interface, so beginners can get into it fairly quickly. It also has the advantage of offering lower fees than the Coinbase website, and you can withdraw any funds for free. So it will be easy for you to move your cryptocurrency from the exchange platform, which is Coinbase Pro, to your own wallet to keep them safe and secure, which I recommend everyone to do. Even though the transaction fees are a bit higher than other exchanges, 0.5 is not that high, but it's higher than other exchanges, which can offer transaction fees low as 0.1%. But they do have a withdrawal fee, which is $3 to $5. So if you already have a Coinbase account, you can easily access this platform. It's the same account. You already have an account. You just log in and you'll get started right away. If not, you should create one. I'll leave the link in the description. Like I said in the beginning, we both received $10 when you sign up with my affiliate link. Any questions you might have, don't be shy. Leave me a comment below and I'll answer any questions you might have. And if you enjoyed this video, please be sure to like it and subscribe if you want to see more content like this. Don't forget about my Bitcoin giveaway. And if you would like $10 worth of Bitcoin for free, like the video, leave a comment below, and maybe you'll be the next lucky winner. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.